just any bill, and if you don't have any, I have some extras. But I count how much I have, so I will get these back. Try to make sure that it's a Chris dollar. And it's better if it's a dollar bill, just so it's easier to follow. But I have a Chris
dollar. All right, all my money.
Yeah. Okay. Boring. I don't have any special talents. I don't really have any hobbies, but I do have interests. And one thing that I'm interested in is money. And I'm sure as college students, you guys are interested in money too, and you like money. But the sad thing is that we don't have much. So say your friend or your roommate's birthday rolls around, and you only have a dollar, maybe five, to spare. And that's all you can afford. And you can't get a card. You don't want to go to the student store and spend even more money on the card. So I'm here to show you how to give a gift of $1 and make it seem cool. So origami is one of my only skills, being Japanese. And and money is what the world revolves around. So I'm going to show you how to make a little shirt like this, and it even has like a little collar, and it's made out of a $1 bill. And if you forget this, if you forget how to do this, you can look it up online, how to fold a dollar bill into a shirt, and the first thing that will come up is Instructables, anything like that, eHow. I got mine from Instructables. So the first thing you do is something that I would say is try to keep it like the same orientation as in the picture, so it's easier to follow on more difficult steps. The Joe Kaplan from Instructables, he said that this is called the 50 cents. So you're just with the Washington's face up, you're going to be folding it in half, meeting the two corners. A tip I use is that I just match up the corners, and then I fold down. I just match up the corners just so they're nice, fold this way, and then I meet in the middle. Oh, geez. And then I meet in the middle. So then it makes like a good fold. And now you're gonna unfold it. So it's Washington is facing you. He's upside down though, he's facing up. And you're gonna take one side and fold it to his nose. Like this. And usually I use my fingernails. I learned this trick from tips for origami at dummies.com, if you'd like to know. Just use your fingernails and swipe so it makes a really crisp line. Really crisp fold. Then, so now it's gonna start getting a little tricky. So the crease, the reason we made the crease earlier, making the 50 cents where we folded the dollar in half, is so we have a guideline, because we're gonna fold the two outside into the middle guideline. Those crisp folds again, with the fingernails. They make like little tiny doors, I suppose. And now on the side that doesn't have the little tiny big ones, you can fold these out into little like isosceles triangles on the side. They're basically making like little sleeves. It's as if like you have your button up and you're going like this. So you're folding those little doors out a little bit. So those are gonna be the sleeves. And is Chris Bolt. And then we're gonna flip it over. So this is the side where you did this, and then you're flipping it over. So it's gonna be on this side with the big one. And on the opposite side of the sleeves, right here, you're gonna be folding it down just like where the little guideline where the dollar printing ends is a good guideline for where you should fold down. Just like that, folding it down like in the picture. This will be your collar. And then the easiest part is basically you're gonna be folding in this time and you're gonna be on this. So if you put the collar down, then you'll be folding little tiny triangles inwards. So the little tips of the ends, they should touch when you fold them in. They're making a little like kind of motion. It should be, so the little flap is on the outside though. So it looks like a little collar. So if your sleeves are on this side, the little sleeves, folding inwards so they touch. Yeah, so the little fold was on this side, and you'll be flipping it over and then touching these little things. And you should have a little tiny collar. Now, once you have that, the easiest part is just folding. So if the little collar's right here, you're just folding and sliding into the collar, and that's the t-shirt. I'll do that again. Make a little crease on the bottom so it stays. So with that, you have your dollar bill t-shirt, and you can simply give this to your friend for their birthday. They might unfold it if they're broke, but they might display it, and it's a really good, it's a really great practice, and origami is actually very beneficial. It improves hand-eye coordination. I learned on origamifun.com that it improves your mind, and it's similar to meditation. It's very calming. So you can use this as a gift now, and you can look it up anytime. Thank you.